This is the solution to quiz three. Okay, so plot point 2, negative 3, so 2, negative 3, and plot 6, 3, so 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3. And the line segment connecting them. Okay, find the distance between the points. Okay, so I can see that, well, to compute part B, on the one hand, we could use the distance formula. So the distance will be the square root of the difference in the x's squared plus the difference in the y's squared, which can be calculated from the formula, so from the individual points. So 2, negative 3, and 6. The other point is 6, 3. So we need to route the points into the correct spot. So I'll put that one there, and that one there. So the difference in the x's and the difference in the y's. So doing that, that'll be the square root of, well, that'd be 2 and then minus 6, square that, plus negative 3 minus 3, square that. So that would be the square root of negative 4 squared, and then plus negative 6 squared. And that is the square root of 16 plus 36, which is 52. And then a 4 can be factored out of that, because that's 4 times 13. So a 2 can come out, and then what's left is 13 inside the radical. So another matter is that with those two, well, before I you just do part C first. For part C, find the midpoint of the line segment and plot it. Okay, so for the midpoint, we'll call that capital M, and that is, we're going to take the point 2, negative 3, and add it to the point 6, 3, and then divide all of that by 2. So that'll be the average x-coordinate, so 2 plus 6 over 2, and then the average y coordinate, negative 3 plus 3 over 2, and that is 4, 0. So you can see the midpoint right there at 4, 0. But as I was saying, to compute the distance, you can also take a look at the plot and just count that this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's why that's a 4. And this one is, so delta x is 4. And then you can count this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that delta y is 6. So you could have used those values and plugged them in over here. That would have worked just fine as well. So delta x is the difference in the x's. And delta y is the difference in the y's. And the negation doesn't make any difference because it's being squared. Okay, so the x-intercept, this is when y is 0. So we'll take that equation and plug in y is 0 to get 2 multiplied by 0 minus 3 multiplied by x is equal to negative 3 minus 3 multiplied by x. So negative 3x is negative 3 minus 3x. And then if you add negative 3x to both sides, I'll add 3x to both sides. Then we are left with the equation 0 equal to negative 3, which is false. And therefore, there is no x-intercept. The y-intercept, if there is one, the condition for this is that this is when x is 0. So we'll take that equation and plug in 0 for x. So that'd be 0 minus 3 times 0 is equal to negative 3 minus 3 times 0. So then that simplifies to 2y minus 2y is negative 3, and so y is negative 3 halves. Therefore, the y-intercept is the point 0, negative 3 halves. Okay. So, as a bit of explanation, if we were to take that equation and just go ahead right now and add 3x to both sides to say, well, 2y minus 3x is negative 3 minus 3x. If we just go ahead and add 3x right now, then that equation is the same as this equation, 2y is negative 3, which is the same as y is negative 3 halves. And if you were to plot this line, then it would be this red line. Y is negative 3 halves. And then, of course, it never touches the x-axis. That's what we concluded up there. And it touches the y-axis right there. Okay. So part A is asking you to perform the substitution. Substitute x, y equal negative 1, negative 2. Let's substitute those in. So if we do that, replacing x with negative 1, that'd be negative 1, and then minus 2 multiplied by, replace y with negative 2, and then equal 3. And the question is, if that is true, well, that would be negative 1, and then plus 4 is 3, so that would say that 3 is 3, which is true, and therefore the answer is yes. Negative 1, negative 2 is part of the graph. Similarly, for part B, we can make the substitution except with 2 and 10. So then it would be 2 minus 2 multiplied by 10 is 3. So 2 minus 20 is 3. And negative 18 is 3. So that's false. And therefore the conclusion is no, it is not part of the graph. Okay, taking that equation and solving for y. So I'll move x to the other side to obtain negative 2y is negative x plus 3. So then y is 1 half x minus 3 halves, because the negative distributes in that way. Okay, so now let's plug in. So if we plug in negative 5 for x, that would be negative 5 halves minus 3 halves. That'd be negative 8 halves, which is negative 4. So negative 4 And then now we're going to go up by half every time. So this would be negative 4 halves minus 3 halves. So negative 4 halves minus 3 halves is negative 7 halves, which is negative 3.5. And it'll just keep going up by half. So negative 3, negative 2.5, negative 2, negative 1.5, negative 1, negative 0.5. This should be 0. Let's check that, make sure I'm following a good pattern. So 3 halves minus 3 halves is 0, good. And then half and 1. So plot every point. Okay, so at negative 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we have the point negative 4. So negative 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, there. And then every time we move to the right, we go up 1 half. So looks like this. All the way to 5. Okay, so here. Okay, so then connecting all those dots. Picture looks like that. And you can see, for example, the point. The point negative 1, negative 2, so this point right here, that's the point negative 1, negative 2, that's in the plot, whereas the point 2, 10, so 2 and then way, way up here, even further, but I can't draw that high, 2, 10, that's not part of the plot, so it's not part of the graph.